All right. Thank you very much for coming tonight to another edition of Beginner Breakdown. I am your host, Mike Kummer. And today we have a very special game. My boss played it. He was playing the white pieces on a game on the Internet Chess Club, the ICC. He is a chess expert. So let's see how he plays, and hopefully we can start playing like him, okay? Yeah, and his name is Alex Marler. Fide Arbiter, very, very, very important. So he starts out e4, the king's pawn up 2. Black counters with e6. This is called the French defense, okay? So a big deficit in the French defense is that this bishop might not ever get the play if white boxes him in, okay? So d4. This is a really good idea in chess. If your opponent didn't attack e4 with knight f6, pawn to f5, or pawn to d5, so your pawn's not attacked, and if he doesn't attack the d4 square with e5 or c5, so if he plays any other move like e6, d6, a6, anything else, just play d4, and now you got these two pawns connected right in the center. Very strong for white. All right, so usually black would play d5 here, going into the French defense, but black plays a little crazy here. He plays h6, okay? Not allowing the bishop or the knight to ever get to g5, all right? So white just continues on the development process with knight to c3. All right. So black plays c6. So now he adds another protector of d5. So he's really preparing d5. All right. So knight f3. Get your knights out. And so now black plays a6. Not very strong. Not very strong. So does anybody play like this, where they're just pushing their side pawns out a lot? So you shouldn't play like that, okay? Just play like white. Get control the center, all right? Because that's the high ground in chess. That's where you want to be playing, okay? So white plays bishop to e2. All right, so does anybody have a better idea where he might want to place the bishop? Or do you think e2 is pretty strong? All right, so another idea might be bishop to d3, and that way, if you ever push e5, if black ever castles over here and you push e5, he'll be attacking this h7 square. A bishop c4 here would not be good, because you'd just be asking him, like, play d5 and attack me, okay? But bishop e2, it's fine for now. He wants to get that bishop off the back row so he can castle. So now he plays d5 finally. And white decides not to do anything about it. He could push, he could take. Why would taking be very... not bad, but not the correct move in this situation? What would that allow black to play here?
E takes d5,
and now his bishop would become free, okay? So we don't want to ever help out our opponents, okay? And by taking, we sure would be, because we'd be trading this pawn for this guy, and we don't want to do that, okay? So he doesn't have to advance. He can just proceed with his own plan of castling. So now he's like, okay, I attacked your pawn, you didn't do anything about it, so I'm gonna take. Or maybe not. So he doesn't take. He decides to play b5. All right? So white sees, hey, he played b5. So you ask yourself, well, he didn't really attack anything with b5, so what's his next logical move when he plays b5? B4, okay? So he didn't want the knight to be attacked, because if the knight gets attacked, all right, b4, remove the defender, okay? The knight has to go, and then the pawn gets taken, okay? So he sees b5, so he doesn't want black to play the move b4. All right, so what move could we play to prevent him from playing b4?
B4?
Yeah, we could play b4, yeah. We could play b4 ourselves. But unfortunately, it's not the best move because unfortunately, nobody is protecting b4, so he could just take. All right, so we want to, if he plays b4, we can take it. So what move would we play?
E5.
So if we play e5, so now we don't have to worry about our knight being, so now the knight's done with his responsibilities, right, of protecting e4. However, if he still plays b4 here, now our knight would probably have to go all the way back, because if he plays here, he's not really doing too much good on the side. And so we don't want him to play b4 because it would have to put our knight in an awkward position, right? Either a4 or back home to b1. So we don't want that to happen. So we really don't want him to play b4 without consequences.
A3.
Very good. So a3. So good. So Alex saw, like, wow, he played b5. He probably wants to play b4. So I'm going to stop it, okay, with a3. Okay, and if he still plays b4, we'll just take it, okay? All right, so now black decides, okay, b5 didn't work. So let me try g5, all right? So he's playing on the other wing here, all right? So why didn't Alex play h3 in this position? Alex?
Say what?
Why didn't you play h3 in this position?
I wasn't afraid of g4.
Okay, so...
You don't need to waste a move to defend against it.
Okay, so if you, like, if b4 happened, right, the knight would either have to go to an awkward position, but if he plays g4 here, let's just say we waste the move, and now he plays g4, were you just going to play him up, or are you going to play him to d2?
95, man.
95, you got to play 95, yeah, 95, okay. So, and then where you were attacking this pawn, okay, and also the pivotal f7, okay. So he wasn't afraid of g4. It didn't have the same punch as b4, so there you go. All right. So Alex takes the pawn. So now if e takes, which is not played, it's actually okay for white here because our king is safe, castled, and his king is dead in the center here. And we can start attacking him with ideas like rook to e1 and so forth, okay? So that's why it's okay for him to take like that here. Okay, but now black's gonna go on with his plan, g4, g5. So now white moves his knight up to e5, attacking the pawn, and also f7 and c6 here. So black protects with h5, all right. So now Alex is looking for some fun right now. So he decides to take on f7 here, okay? Forking the queen and the rook, all right? Look at how black's pieces are. Playing the back row defense here, okay? Everybody is just on the back row, all right? So this is a good time to sacrifice material because, I mean, he's got nothing going on. He's got nothing. So king takes. Well, king should take. If somebody's going to offer you material and you don't see a good good defense to it, it's best to just take it and just say, hey, prove it, all right? Prove why your sacrifice was good. Unless you calculate out, wow, if I take this, I'm going to get checkmate in two moves. Then don't play it. But there's no excuse for Black not to take this this knight now. Because if he plays queen to c7 and I take your rook, I'm just down a rook for nothing, right? And that's no fun. Eventually, I'll be able to get the knight back. But then I'll still just be down in exchange. So queen to c7. And now Alex decides just to keep pressing the pedal to the metal. Who would take the rook in this position? There we got one, two. Yeah, I would definitely take the rook too, because hey, I'm up five points here. I mean, and good luck. I mean, knight takes, and then I guess Black would zoom his queen over here to win the knight back. But still, you'd be up in exchange, and you'd be doing pretty well. Okay, but he decides to get adventurous because knight's on f7. So he decides to protect it. Pawn takes, protecting the knight here, okay? So what should Black do? He's got to save his rook, right? All right, so rook there. The only place the rook can go to be saved. All right. So let's see what he can do here. So he wants to protect that pawn some more. So he plays a d5. So now he's got the rook going, just like h7, so he's on a7. All right. Very interesting. All right. So bishop attacks the rook.
Mike, I have to say, I could not predict any of my opponents.
Right, yes. He's very playing on each wing, you know, just taking his time, that wing, so. But huge space event. All right, so now he decides to ignore Alex's threat of bishop takes rook and play his pawn here. So he's threatening pawn takes check. Very interesting. So who would take the rook on a7 now? He's offering the rook again.
I would.
All right, so we're not afraid of pawn takes pawn. And then king h1. Yeah, I don't think I'd be afraid of it either. All right, but he decides to avoid the shenanigans and get an extra protector on this knight here.
Point of
notice,
I was playing for mate.
Yes, and okay.
The materials.
Yeah. So this is a blitz game, and he doesn't want to just trade, even though it would be good, because he wants to get the game over as quick as possible. But sometimes, you know, if you see just trade and win, as a beginner, I would definitely take any advantage you can get, because this mate might not ever come. But who knows? It might. Probably. Because I've seen the game. All right. So h4, so he keeps attacking, but his attacks not really doing too much. All right, so he wants to bust open this H file to get his queen down here and mate him, which it wouldn't even be mate. Okay, so he decides to attack another rook. Now, if this rook doesn't move, do you think Alex is gonna take it? That's the big question. That's the big question. Let's see. But I think he's gonna move the rook though. All right, he's moving the rook. All right, rook to G7. All right.
What move are we on?
Probably about 14 or so.
14 and no bishops and no black knights have moved at all.
Right. Yeah. Not very good for Black. We're deep into this game, and all his pieces are in the back row. That's what you get when you play h6, a6, c6 in the opening, e6. You're not getting your pieces off the back row, your minor pieces. You're not getting castled. And look at what happened. Your king's still stuck in the center of the board, and it's not looking very good for black here, okay? So he moved his rook out to g7. And now queen to f3. So this is going to get bad for black pretty soon. So now he's eyeing all along this f file here, all right? So all he has to do is get his knight out of the way, and he's threatening queen takes bishop, checkmate, all right? So let's see if he can figure this out. All right, so he gets his queen closer to the bishop, all right? So that was a good one. All right, so queen protects the bishop. So in this position, all right, well, what's wrong with rook takes knight here? Let's say if we could, black would probably want to trade his rook, queen, and rook for this queen, rook, knight, and pawn, right? But there's a big flaw with rook takes knight here. Can anybody see it? All right, we have another expert in the audience here, Joey G.
I could be wrong, but he's played bishop g6.
Yeah, bishop g6 looks pretty good. Yeah, we can just keep it pretty simple. Bishop g6. All right, and then knight h6 to protect it doesn't work because we just remove the defender. Make sense? All right, so, but he didn't really try any of that. So after queen f3, he just played the move queen to e7 to protect the bishop, all right? All right, so now attack, very good. Pawn attacks the queen. So he's got to move the queen. If he moves queen f6, he loses at least a knight. So he doesn't want to take d6, obviously, because the knight protects. So he's got to just take here, okay? So black's probably feeling pretty good right now, huh? He just got a pawn. He's like, wow, this guy, what happened to this guy? He was playing so well. All right. So what move do you think Alex does to make him pay here?
It's a trick.
You'll see why. It's a
Bishop takes rook.
Bishop takes rook. You remember, he wants the mate. He wants the checkmate. So let's see. Without further ado, drum roll. Bishop takes rook is the winning move. All right. So he got him. Good job, Keith. Keith Bass. You get an extra batch of popcorn for that one. All right, so now the knight. So he should probably really take the knight here, but he doesn't. He doesn't take the knight. Interesting. All right, so
what happens if, like, look at rook takes up 7.
Yeah, rook takes up 7, yeah. And you're only up by 12 points right now after queen to h5. Queen to h5. So yeah, we just pin it, but yeah, with the queen this time.
Okay.
All right, so instead he plays a pretty bad knight to d7. Develops a piece, yeah. But leaves his pawn hanging here. But yeah, more importantly, boom, rook to e1, get the rook, queen, pawn on the same line. And it's not looking very good for black here. So knight to e5. Did that do anything to stop him from losing the rook for the queen? No, because we can just take like this. But Alex decides to be funny and take like this, because he remembers if queen takes f8, it's checkmate, right? So do you think black's going to stop that? No. So yeah, just keep streaming about this attack and boom. All right, so that's checkmate. That's the game. So hopefully we learned some stuff from the game. We want to get our minor pieces off the back row early so we can get castled, so our king doesn't hang out in the center of the board at all times. It's very advisable to sacrifice material when none of black's players are playing, right? When nobody's playing, right? Does that make sense? So that was a good job by Alex here. All right, we got one last game. It's brought in from an audience member as well. He's how long have you been playing chess for?
Did it in middle school and
past
month and a half.
So he played earlier in life, as probably many of them, and then he decided, hey, I'm going to get back at chess and start playing. So what he does is he does a good way to get better at chess, okay? So he's been playing back up at the club for a month and a half, coming to some of the classes, and playing chess online, okay? So chess.com is a good site. The Internet Chess Club is also a very, very well. So that's how you want to get better, okay? So here we go. All right, so he's got the black pieces in this game, correct? You're the angry man?
I'm angry man.
All right, he's the angry manatee. All right, so he's playing black. Okay, so white starts out e4. As most beginners, they're going to counter with e5, okay? So white should obviously play knight to f3 to attack the pawn, but he decides to play d3. Weak move, d3, okay? You're not, you know, going into your opponent's territory. You're not making any threats. You're actually boxing in your bishop. You're playing very passively, okay? Not recommended, okay? So knight to c6. Knight to f3 attacks the pawn, but it's already defended. So he doesn't have to really do anything about that. Knight f6. Now white starts playing some good developing moves. Knight to c3. So he sees a piece that can be pinned. So he pins it with bishop to b4. Whenever, king, whenever two pieces are in the same line, either diagonally, horizontally, or vertically, you know, pieces can be pinned. So he pinned it. So this knight is now a stuck piece, okay? A pinned piece that can't move, stuck. So I get all the credit for that, okay? So now you know, a pinned piece that can't move, it's stuck, all right? Stuck piece, knight to c3, all right? So white could play bishop to d2 and break the pin, but he's not afraid of these double pawns after g3. So did you think about giving him double pawns in this position?
I did, actually.
But you decided, it would open up this file for the rook. So, I don't know. Maybe you want to give him double pawns, maybe you don't. I don't know. But all right. So after g3, you have a chance to castle. It's always good to just get castled when you can castle, all right? If you were planning on castling over there, I would do it, okay? As soon as you can, okay? Because you always have time to play after g3. You always have time to do d6, right? And these ideas. But you might not always have the chance to castle, okay? Castle, I mean, this is like your $9 billion lottery ticket, right? So if you had a $9 billion lotto ticket, right, wouldn't you want to go to the bank first and then go get gas and a snack, right, after you're castled and safe? Or would you, all right, well, I'm going to play this first. And then you get sidetracked, and maybe you never make it to the bank, okay? So you want to get them castled as soon as you can, all right? So d6, bishop to g5. So now The knight is in a pin, but he's not stuck because he can move, all right? So bishop to g5. So now bishop to g4 pins the knight. So you guys are making a lot of pins, but you're not really doing anything with them, okay? So when pieces are in pins, you want to find a way to attack the pinned piece, okay? You don't want to be like, look at me, I just pinned them, haha. And then it's just like, well, you're pinned. Well, it's like, do something, make them pay for being in a pin, right? All right, because if you don't make them pay, it's like, then what's the point, right? All right, so white plays a really dubious move here. So, let's take a vote. Do we want to play bishop to e2 or bishop to g2? Who says e2? What? All right, David, you with me? Bishop to g2? You with me, David? Who's saying bishop to g2? All right, because if you play bishop to e2, what's a really funny move that black can play in this position? And it's not castling, okay? Bishop to h3, right. You want to castle over here? Forget about it, all right? Right, so that's why in the opening, you really want to have some ideas when you're playing these moves, like, do I want to castle kingside? Where do I want to put my bishop? By putting his pawn on d3 early, it totally stopped him from playing it to like cool squares like c4, where you're attacking f7, or b5, where you're pinning the knight, okay? All right, and then you play g3. A logical move after g3 is to play bishop to g2 and get castled over here, right? But you're like, oh, well, I don't want to be in a pin. That'd be horrible. So bishop to e2. And now, correct, your knight's not in a pin anymore. But bishop to h3 should just crush him. All right? So after bishop to h3, the computer recommends the bishop go to f1 and that would totally lose his castle then. And it would still give black an advantage. Okay? So all right, so he did go to bishop to e2. And so now black decides, oh, okay, I got a castle, okay? All right, so he didn't play bishop to h3. So now white obviously should castle when he has the chance, right? Because bishop h3 could come in at any time. Bishop h3, we wouldn't have to worry about it right now because we can just play our rook to e1. Okay? So let's see what happens here. All right. White decides to play queen to d2. So now the knight is no longer stuck, but it's still in a pin because if it moves, we'll take the queen. All right. So queen to d2. So now black decides, I don't like this knight being in a pin, so I'm going to play h6. So very interesting here. So now white is put to the test here. He's got some ideas. He can take the knight, retreat back to h4, go back to e3, or capture the pawn. So white decides to be adventurous and sacrifice his bishop for two pawns here, okay? And the idea is he wants to get checkmate. However, his pieces, a queen cannot checkmate the king, at least not in this position all by itself. Very rarely can a queen checkmate a king all by itself, unless there's a back row checkmate situation going on, which obviously in this case there is none. So it's going to be really tough for this queen, you know, to check. It's impossible for this queen alone to checkmate black. And let's look at all of his other pieces. All pretty weak, huh? Bishop sitting here. The knight is the only other contender, huh? So in this position, if I was him, I would be like, you're out of here, knight. Okay, and then proceed with knight to h7. Because this bishop is no threat to me. He'd have to go here and then here. And by then, let's just say we play knight h7 and he plays bishop here. What move can we play as black to try and just get rid of all the threats here? Because we're up a piece for two pawns. So if we trade down to an end game, we're going to win. And when we're on the defense, which we are right now, we want to trade pieces. When we're on the defense, let's trade some pieces. Oh man, somebody is pretty good in this class. Well, yeah, the move I would have recommended, he said, yes, queen to g5, forcing the queens off the board. All right, a move like some other people might have recommended that will remain nameless. Queen to f6 doesn't get the job done because he can retreat, right? Queen to g5 essentially traps in the queens, okay? And that's what we would want to do. Because once he trades queens, count up our pieces, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. He's only got 1, 2, 3, 4. We're gonna have a pretty easy game to win this. All we have to do is make sure that he doesn't get this pawn to become a queen, and we got it, okay? Excellent, all right. So, but that's not how the game goes. He plays knight to h7 right away. But he's still threatening queen to g5 here. All right, and now, very strange move here of white. He just sacrificed a material and he decides to castle, a defensive move, all right? So now black should play queen to h5, or queen to g, well, no, he shouldn't play queen to g5 here because the knight's still there. But still the same idea is good. Bishop takes knight, bishop takes bishop, and now queen to g5, and black would be in business, okay? So when you're up material, remember, you want to trade material, okay? So trading the bishop and the knight and the queens would be excellent. All right, but he decides to play knight to d4. Lucky for him, it's illegal, but not anymore. Knight to d4, so usually, knight to d4 would never work, okay? Because after knight takes knight, right, bishop takes, knight takes, and you just traded 2 for 1. But luckily, this is a special circumstance. You all see that? Knight to d4? So you take my knight, and then I take, but then look at what I can do. I can just take it right back, okay? So that's not a good move usually, but after knight to d4, if he takes, which if he would take, we can take pawn takes here, and now if we take the bishop, we can take the knight. But now this is kind of interesting. What should white do to threaten checkmate here? Bishop f5, threatening checkmate. Does anybody have any defenses for black? You better, or else you lost. I only see one good move for black. But who knows, there might be a guy in the audience trying to outshine me here tonight. So you don't want queen takes knight checkmate to happen, right? Can we all agree? Good. So.
Rook to
e8. Okay, so this is an idea. Okay, so let's create a flight square for our king. Unfortunately, We just lost our precious knight, though, okay? And maybe we don't need to lose the knight. Okay, so rook to e8, it did stop checkmate for the record, but unfortunately it lost the knight. So if we just move the knight to f6, okay, now he can't play queen to h7 checkmate. But he can play, he can go to for a perpetual check now. Okay, makes sense. If you repeat the position three times, it's a draw. So in this position, knight f6 would be the best move. But if you're like, I don't want a draw, you could play rook to e8, and then you wouldn't get a draw. But you might not get a draw just playing the game. You might actually lose though. So all right. So after knight to d4 here. White decides to do none of that. He decides to play h4. And now he tries to get the attack. But this attack is not going to happen. And plus, he just flat out lost a piece, huh? All right, so they got to pay attention to the opponent's moves here. So bishop takes f3, bishop takes f3, knight takes check. King to g2. Okay, so this is very important here, okay? So unfortunately, black makes a mistake here. And not only for the flat out reason he makes a mistake, for another reason too. All right, so we just played king to g2. What move do we want to play as black here? Anybody got any ideas? Well, now you're just being crazy.
You told me you wanted to take
it. Well, there's no reason to give back material if we don't have to, right? You wouldn't really play knight takes h4 in the game. He's just being silly. Anybody? You got any ideas? Knight where? Knight d2. That's what's played in the game. Okay? And that's the incorrect move for two reasons. Okay, one is the obvious move, which we'll get to in a second. But the second move is he can play rook to d1, and does your knight have anywhere to go? After rook d1? No. So you just trapped yourself. I mean, I know it's cool to attack a rook, but it's got no place to go. So what's the obvious move white plays in this position? And this is what is actually played in the game. Queen takes d2. You just put the knight on the same line as the queen. So the move obviously was knight to d4 in this position after king g2, knight just back to d4. Okay? Unfortunately, knight d2, and we take it. All right, queen takes d2. So he's making a little bit of a comeback here. All right, so black plays c6. He still wants to attack this knight because it's still a pinned piece here. All right, so white goes back up to h6. And now black gets the idea, hey, let's trade queens. I'm up a piece. Better late than never, okay? Queen to f6, queen to h5. And now he's like, he gets an idea and he's sticking to it, huh? Queen to g6, which is good. Queen to f3. And this is cool. All right, and f5. All right, just break it open. He's like, I'll attack your queen. I'm like, all right, I'll move. Pretty easy stuff. He's like, well, better move my queen back. E2. Queen to E2. Oh, okay. So he didn't go to G5. Obviously, if you've been watching the last three moves, he's going to offer another queen trade, right? So queen g5, and queen to e2. All right, there's not really a tactic here, but you could try to just remove the defender here. Hope he takes and win the queen, but that's all right. Because after bishop takes, he would take, check, take, and then it would give him double pawns. But all right, so we end up just taking. Knight takes, all right. And so now we're up a bishop here, pure profit bishop, so this is good. So black proceeds knight f6. And now white does not want to lose this pawn, so what do you think he plays? H6 would work. Rook h1 is what it's actually played. And we got about 3 minutes to wrap this guy up. All right, so let's see the chilling conclusion of this game. So f takes e4. He decides not to take back. All right, he decides to play f3. Not a good move, f3, because what can black play here? Just take it, right? Take, king takes, and then guess what? Knight takes pawn, check, right? Rook can't take it, because guess what? Rook, king, in the same line, discovered check, all right? But he decides, I'm going to get a passed pawn, e3. So that's kind of a cool idea, too. I mean, I probably would have just taken, but all right, so this could be a nuisance for white here. So f4 takes, knight takes f4. Okay, knight to g4. Now he can use this e pawn to his advantage here. And so he decides he's got h6. He says he wants a queen too. So very interesting. Who do you think has a better chance of actually getting and maintaining a queen in this position? White or black? We'll see. We'll see. That's why we do this, to see. All right, so king h7, he's like, you're not getting any further. All right, knight e6 attacks the rook. So let's move the rook. Very good. Rook f2, check. King to h3 attacks the knight. If we really like our knight on this position, we could protect it, but he decides, I'm going to just eliminate the threat right away. I like it. So king to h4. All right. Kind of weird just moving the king up, but that's all right. All right. So e2, all right. He wants it. Oh, look at this. King to g5. You don't see this every day. A discovered attack. Boom. And the king attack in the pin piece. All right. Very, very interesting. So there's a really cool way to protect this knight here. Yeah, bishop to d2 check. Pretty cool. Rook to g8, pretty cool. So yeah, bishop to d2 check, excellent. All right. It's really cool. Sorry, can't play it. I guess game's over. What happened? All right, bishop to d2 check. All right, so he's got to get out of this check and back to h4 he goes. So the idea of king here didn't really work out for white. All right, so rook to e8 gets his rook behind the pawn. All right. So he puts him in a check, king to g6. Knight to e4. So he forks the bishop and the rook. So what do we do here? What do we do? Knight to f5, check. King to h3. Grandmaster Ben Feingold is here. He'll be starting his lecture in about 2 minutes, everybody. 2 minutes after the chilling conclusion of this game. King h3.
Chilling or thrilling?
Both. Rook to h8, check. King to g4. All right, now we just take the rook.
Excuse me, sir.
Rook. Oh, hold on one sec.
I have a question.
Is somebody in check or something?
No, instead of rook takes h1, no, rook h8.
Is there a checkmate here we're missing?
Knight e3 checkmate? Yeah. That might be better.
All right, so Ben Feingold is recommending that we just go straight for the checkmate here. And then he gets then he gets the lecture. So knight to e3. I always look for your checks, and that's a pretty good one. All right. Well, unfortunately, doesn't get it. Rook takes h1. So he decides play rook to f1. And it's not looking very good for white anyway. All right. Knight takes d2. Knight gets a queen. Well, actually, he takes the rook first. And black is crushing here. All right. He's got mates all over the board and a queen. And life is good. He's got that now. And now, even if you're not Ben Feingold, you can see this checkmate.
Large wager against
them. Rook to h3. Wow, I bet against them. Yeah, rook to h3, checkmate. Good job for our beginner, okay?
Solid.
Yes, solid. All right, good night.